Hello everyone, my name is Arohi and welcome to my channel. So guys, in my today's video we will cover Fastorwit model. Fastorwit is a fast vision transformer model developed by NVIDIA. So in this tutorial we'll begin by understanding what Fastorwit is, and then I'll show you how to use pre-trained model for image classification, and finally I'll show you how to work with custom dataset. So by the end of this tutorial you'll be able to build your own custom Fastorwit model. Okay, so this is one of the video output video. Here you can see we are performing image classification on each frame of the video, and by the end of this tutorial you will be able to perform this kind of classification on your custom data set. So let's get started. Let's start by understanding what Fastorwit is. So Fastorwit is a variant of vision transformer architectures, and it is designed to address some of the performance and efficiency challenges associated with traditional transformer models in computer vision tasks. Vision transformers originally come from transformer architectures that were initially developed for natural processing tasks, right? So in 2020, researchers discovered that vision transformers could also work with images. So how it works with images? So we divide the image into patches first, then it flattens them and then process these patches as a sequence using transformer model. Okay. While WITs have shown promising results in image classification, they often require significant computational resources and have long inference time due to their complexity. So Fastorwit, here comes the Fastorwit. Fastorwit is designed to be more computationally efficient than the standard WITs. So this is achieved through architectural changes that reduces the number of parameters and floating point operations required for inference. Now let's talk about Fastorwit in little detail. So it is a neural network architecture designed for handling high resolution images with fast processing capabilities. Okay, so this is the main goal behind the Fastorwit. Fastorwit combines the strength of convolutional neural network and vision transformers to create highly efficient and effective model for computer vision tasks. So in Fastorwit, we are using CNNs also and transformers also. We are using them together. If you see the architecture of Fastorwit, here you can see that in the early stages of Fastorwit architecture, CNNs are used to capture high resolution features from the input images, because CNNs are known for their efficiency in learning local representations or features within the small range of the image. Okay, and for example, let's understand this with an example. So imagine you have an image of cat, and in the early stages CNN will identify the basic features such as edges or textures or simple shapes like the outline of the cat, ears or whiskers, right? These kind of things. So this is the task of CNN. So when you will pass the input image to the Fastorwit first, in early stages we will use CNN to extract the features, as I've shared the example with you. Okay, and in later stages the model will use transformer to process high level tokens, which are more abstract representations of the image. Okay, so let's continue with that cat example only. So after CNN layers have identified the basic features of the cat, then the transformer layers will start understanding the context, such as recognizing that these features together form the image of a cat. Fastorwit also includes a novel hierarchical attention mechanism that combines local and global attention efficiently. This allows the model to capture both fine details and the broader context simultaneously. Now, what is local attention? So, local attention mechanism focuses on small regions or windows of the image, ensuring that the detailed information within these regions is captured accurately. Okay. And the global attention mechanism ensures that there is a communication between these local regions to understand the broader context. So by using this hierarchical structure, the mechanism reduces the computational complexity, which makes the model faster and more efficient. This is just a basic introduction about the Fastorwit model. Now let's see how to use pre-trained Fastorwit model and how to perform inference on images and videos. Okay, so for that, first we will set up our environment where we are going to run this code, and then I'll show you the example. So guys, here, this is the official repo of Fasterwit by NVIDIA, and if you scroll down here, yeah, so you just need to run this one command, pip install Fasterwit to install the Fasterwit model. Okay, and then we will use this script to load the pre-trained model and then to perform the testing. Let's see how to do that. So for that, I'm opening command prompt, and I have my code in E drive. And guys, I always recommend to work in a separate environment. So for this tutorial also, I've created a separate environment. So let's enter in the folder where I have created the environment. So this is the folder. Here, I'm activating the environment now. Right, now let me show you the Python version I'm using. So the Python version is this. Now let me show you the PyTorch version. For that, just write Python and write import torch. Now write torch dot underscore underscore version. So here you can see I am using PyTorch 2.2.2 and it is compiled with CUDA 12.1. I'm opening the Jupyter notebook. Through the Jupyter notebook, I'll show you the code. So let's open the Jupyter notebook. Okay, here. So this is the code, and I have provided the link in description section. You can get this code from there and try it. Now opening this file to explain you the code. So first we are importing the torch. These are all required modules, and to use the Fasterwit model, you need to import it like this. And as I've told you that first we are going to see how to use pre-trained model. So this is how you download the pre-trained model in your working directory. So create model, and this is the name of the model, pre-trained true. And this TMP is a folder name. This you have to create in your current working directory, and inside that, this model will be downloaded. Okay, so when you run this code for the very first time, the download will start, and under your TMP folder, you will get a trained model like this, pre-trained model like this. So Fasterwit is, guys, trained, pre-trained on ImageNet dataset, which have 1,000 different classes. So this, using this model, you can classify those different 1,000 classes. Okay, this is the first step, and after that, let me run it for you. And after that, this is the second step. Over here, we are just writing the transformations which we want to perform on the image which we will provide to our model. Here, this is the image which I will provide to the Fasterwit pre-trained model. And we are opening the image, and then we are performing all the pre-processing steps which we have defined here, right? And this is how the model will accept the input. So that's what we are doing. And then we are moving that image to the device. Device is CUDA 0. So this is how you do that. And then here we are running the model. So model, and we are providing this input batch. What is there in this input batch? So we have our input in our input image. Now let's execute all these cells to show you the output. I've executed here and this step and this, and here we are running the model, right? Now let's just print this output. When you print the output, as I've told you that this pre-trained model is trained on ImageNet dataset, and it has 1,000 different classes, and when you print it, you'll get the 1,000 different values as output. See, so this kind of output you will get, but we don't want output in this form. We want it in a more understandable form, right? So for that, we are using this function, softmax function, over here on the output, this output. Okay, and then we are just picking the top five classes with the top five probability values. And here, when you'll execute this cell, this kind of output you'll get. category ID 207. This is the class ID 208, 852, 220, and 219. So these are the class IDs and these are the probabilities. So there is 72% probability that the image which we have provided to the model belongs to this class ID, this category ID. Okay. So now let's say we don't want to have the category IDs, we instead want to have the class names. Okay, instead of these class IDs, we need a class names. For that, we need to first download the class names of ImageNet. So all the class names of ImageNet are present at this location. So this, and then I'm just creating a ImageNet class index.json file, and in that file I am using a dictionary. So there will be a key and a value. Key will be the class ID and value will be the class name. Okay, so when you'll execute this cell, you will see this JSON file in your current working directory. Now let me show you that file first. So it is over here. Let's open it. Okay, just give me a minute, guys. So here you can see 0 class ID belongs to this class, 1 belongs to this class, 2 belongs to this class, like this. Okay, so this is this kind of file, JSON file we have created. And now we have all the classes and their class IDs. Here we are just loading that file in this variable. Once you load that file, here in probabilities, what we are doing is, here we are getting the top 5 values, and inside that, over here, we have added one more line. So guys, see, if you'll go above here, so this is the same code we are going to use. Over here, additionally, I just added this one line, ID to labels. Okay, this will provide you the class name instead of the class ID, and this golden retriever or this Labrador retriever, these kind of classes. So they all are different dog breeds. So let me show you the input image first, the input image we are working on. So this is the input. So this is the input which we have provided to our model, and our model is saying that 72% probability is that this dog belongs to breed, and then like this, these are the top 5 probabilities. Okay, now let's say you want to show the output image on the screen and you also want to show the label on it. So for that, we are just using this PIL module and matplotlib module, and we added this one line. Okay, so we are getting the predicted class names and the probabilities, and this is how we have shown it. So this is the output using the pre-trained model on image. Now let's say if you want to work on a video. So video means you have multiple frames, right? Video consists of multiple frames. So if you want to work on a video, so you need to fetch every frame and you have to perform classification on all the frames individually. So that's what we are going to do now. See, this is the whole code. I have written whole code over here. We are loading the pre-trained model, we are loading the class names, and this is the video on which we want to work. We are reading the video using OpenCV, and then here, this is a pre-process step. On each frame, we want to use this pre-processing step. Okay, so if cap is open, means if you are reading the frames of the video, and we are resizing each frame of the video to this particular size. So this is an optional step, you can even leave it. So we are resizing all the frames, we are converting those frames into PIL image, we are applying the pre-processing step on it, and then we are converting the input into the format which our model accepts, and then we are sending all those frames one by one to the device, and then here we are applying the model on each frame. And then we are getting the top 5 probabilities like this. And on each frame, we are putting the class name and the probability by using this cv2.putText. And will show you each frame. So let's run it and see. So this is our video, and here you can see the output. So you are getting class sorrel over here right now. Maybe this is a different horse breed. So yeah, so this kind of output you will get. And let me show you, let's test on one more video. So let's say instead of this, let me see what all videos I have over here. B1. Okay. Now let's test on another video. So this is the another video. So it's sometimes it's saying fireboat and then speedboat. Okay. So this is how you can perform image classification using FasterWit, and here we have used the pre-trained model. So guys, now check this video. I have given the link of next video in description section also. So in next video, I have explained to you step by step how to work with custom data set. So I hope this video is helpful. So guys, if you like my content, please like, share, and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.